There is a king with a crown.
Oh, what shall I do with this boy? What shall I do? What shall I do? If you don't learn to tell the truth, I'll have to spank you. Go back and see who it is and ask them what they want. I should say not.
There are two kings.
Ooh, what shall I do with this boy? What shall I do? What shall I do? Hurry back and see who it is, and don't you dare make up tales.
Mother, 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 come with me. If I tell you the truth, I know you won't believe me.
Try it for a change.
But you won't believe me.
I'll believe you if you tell me the truth.
Sure enough, there are not two kings outside.
That is surprising.
The kings are three, and one of them is black.
Oh, what shall I do with this boy? If you were stronger, I'd like to whip you.
I knew it.
I'm going to the door myself. Then, young man, you'll have to reckon with me.
The mother welcomes the kings and offers what little hospitality she and Amal can give. While she goes to get some wood from the neighbors, Amal tells the kings that he was a shepherd before he became crippled, but mother had to sell their sheep to make ends meet. He talks to the deaf king Caspar, and when Amal asks about his luggage, Caspar replies, "The little area, this is my box."
Are you a real king?
Yes.
Have you regal blood?
Yes.
Can I see it?
It is just like yours.
What's the use of having it then?
No use.
Where is your home?
I live in a black marble palace full of black panthers and white doves. And you, little boy, what do you do?
I was a shepherd. I had a flock of sheep. But my mother sold them. Now there are no sheep left. I had a black goat who gave me warm, sweet milk. But she died of old age. Now there is no goat left. But mother says that now we shall both go begging from door to door. Won't it be fun?
It has its points.
Are you a real king too?
Eh?
Are you a real king too?
Oh, truly, yes, I am a real king. Am I not?
Yes, Caspar.
What is that?
Eh?
What is that?
A parrot.
Does it talk?
Eh?
Does it talk?
How do I know?
Does it bite?
Eh?
Does it bite?
Yes.
And what is this?
This is my box. This is my box. I never travel without my box. In the first drawer I keep my magic stones. One carnelian against all evil and envy. One moonstone to make you sleep. One red coral to heal your wounds. One lapis lazuli against wart and fever. One small jasper to help you find water. One small topaz to soothe your eyes. One red ruby to protect you from lightning. This is my box, this is my box. I never travel without my box. In the second drawer I keep all my beads. Oh, how I love to play with beads. All kinds of beads. This is my box, this is my box. I never travel without my box. In the third drawer. In the third drawer. Oh, little boy, oh, little boy, in the third drawer I keep licorice, licorice, black sweet licorice, black sweet licorice. Have some.
When the mother returns, the kings tell her they are summoned to a child with mild eyes and the hands of a king, for whom they are bringing gold, incense, and myrrh. She replies her child possesses those attributes, but is sick and poor, and no one brings him any gifts.
Amal, I told you not to be a nuisance.
But it isn't my fault. They kept asking me questions.
I want you to go and call the other shepherds. Tell them about our visitors and ask them to bring whatever they have in the house, as we have nothing to offer them. Hurry on.
Yes, Mother.
The gifts to the child.
The child? Which child?
We don't know, but but the star will guide us to him.
But perhaps I know him.
Other shepherds arrive at the hut, bringing baskets of fruits and vegetables for the kings, and they serenade and dance for the visitors.
Shepherds, who's calling? The shepherds are coming!
Wake up, Casper.